Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we talk about the next phrase in this amazing one ayah about Ramadan. Allah says, wa litukmilul iddah. So all of you complete the count. So that all of you complete the count. Allah is now, tie this together. He says He sent the month of Ramadan. Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed. And then He describes the Quran. Then He says, whoever among you is going to witness this month should fast in its entirety. And then He says, I want things to be easy for you. He doesn't want things to be hard for you. And He wants things to be easy and not hard so that you complete the count. Meaning, that phrase that He wants things to be easy and not hard is actually also tied to the concept of fasting. He will make sure that it's easy, and so easy that you will be able to complete the count. And He made it possible for you to make up those days. He doesn't say, it doesn't matter if you're sick or not, you better fast. No, if you're sick and you're traveling and it's difficult, make it up in other times. Because I want to make this easy for you so you can complete your training. I'll give you these relaxations so you can complete the count. وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةِ. And by mentioning the word عِدَّة, Allah is highlighting to us the importance of this training period. Like, this time is actually a really important time. And each fast is valuable. You know, when we get into the month of Ramadan, in the beginning, you're like a little bit fired up. Then a week in, and you're going to go, well, I'll probably recharge my batteries in the last week when the odd nights happen again. Allah is giving in the Quran this profound value to the entire count. Like, every day is a rigorous, important day for your transformation. It's this 30-day intensive that you're going through. So don't just think of it as deprivation of food and sleep and, you know, intimacy. That's not all this is. This is a program for your and my complete transformation. And each of these days is extremely valuable. When He says, وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةِ, every single day counts. So you may complete and perfect. Kamal in Arabic isn't just for completing. It's actually also for perfecting. So you perfect the count. Every day should be awesome. Every day is a quiz. Every day of Ramadan is like a quiz. And you've got to ace that quiz. You've got to do your very, very best. You know, the way you speak, the way you control your temper, the way you, if you're used to just talking about people, don't talk about people, even the people that make you upset. Even the people that, you know, your friends are calling you, talking about people. No, we're not going to talk about anybody. We're going to talk about Allah. We'll talk about His messenger. Or we're going to talk about who we're going to help. That's it. No, but I want to talk about what wrong they did and what they said. And it made me so angry. Nope. We're not going to talk. We're fasting from all of that. No, we're not fasting from. We're just fasting from food. No, we're fasting from our tongues also. We're fasting from saying bad things also. That idea that we're going to perfect each day. We're going to become conscious. So just like we are conscious of food and drink, just like that, we're going to become conscious of everything else. How we spend our time. We're not going to waste hours entertaining ourselves. We're not going to just lie around doing nothing. We were created for a purpose. The Prophet ﷺ, this Qur'an was given to him, and the rest of his life was driven by this purpose. These 30 days, when you live purposefully, you start thinking about how to value your time. It's not just about prayers. In between, every prayer is supposed to recalibrate your purpose. So from this prayer to next prayer, what valuable thing did you do? What did you do to benefit yourself? What did you do to benefit someone else? What did you do for this life? What did you do for the next life? These are the questions we're going to start asking ourselves. And as we do that, the petty things in life, the things that don't have any value, that become very big to us, they start becoming small. They are no longer a big deal. Then you don't care about the clothes and which party and who said what and, you know, keeping up with whatever social standards and, you know, money and, all of these petty things, they start disappearing. And the people who you think are the biggest problems in your life, or you're worried about this one or worried about that one or arguments with this, all of those things, you realize that you are in the hands of Allah. You're conscious and aware of Allah. He's the one protecting you. He's the one training you. You let go of your fear of everybody else. That's part of the meaning of taqwa, of having a consciousness of Allah, purpose. You know, just like you're afraid of Allah before you drink that glass of water or you eat that food before, you know, when you're fasting, the same way you're going to develop, well, if I'm afraid of Allah in this, then I really shouldn't be afraid of anybody else. You let go of your anxiety and fear of people. Train your mind in these things and every day becomes perfected. وَلِتُكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةِ. How will it become perfected? How will your mindset change? Well, that's the key, isn't it? Recite Qur'an. Contemplate Qur'an in the days of the fast. In the nights of the fast. Contemplate. Think about what Allah is saying. Don't finish. You don't have to finish the entire Qur'an. You don't have to finish reciting the whole thing or reading the translation of the whole thing. Whatever you recite every day, think a lot about what Allah is saying. And I can guarantee you, your heart and your mind is going to start experiencing a profound, profound transformation, especially in this month. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.